Hey, it's Amy with Ask a Christian. Our question today is from Joanna, who wants to know why the creation days seem so out of order, so illogical in their lineup. And she wants to know, is this not a sign that the Bible could be baloney? Ah, thank you for your question, Joanna, and you are absolutely right. It does seem wild. The lineup of the creation days seems completely illogical. How could God have separated the light from the darkness, the day and the night be the first day, before the sun was even on the scene in day four? Let me give you a little rundown of some of the ideas that other people have proposed, and then towards the end, I'll start letting you know why I believe what I believe and how I think it makes God look awesome. Just a reminder to anybody watching this, this is geared towards people who already have sort of a Christian bend. This is not gonna give tons of evidence for creation or anything like that, but if you grew up Christian and had wondered this, it might just make sense to you. Option number one is to dismiss the whole creation account as allegorical or just not literal at all. Some Jewish scholars and Christian scholars have suggested that the creation story is not to be read literally, so we don't even have to worry about what happened on which days or whether it was a single day of creation or done over an epoch of time. It's not literal anyway. It's supposed to simply let you know that God prepared the earth to be habitable by mankind. A second view is that the days of creation are not actually listed chronologically. In this way of thinking, several puzzling problems are easily solved. For example, the light and the darkness and the creating of the celestial bodies likely happened on the same day, and their separation in the book of Genesis is more stylistic than realistic. Lastly, the view that I kind of lean towards is that the author, commonly understood to be Moses, was conveying literally and chronologically the history of Earth's beginnings, and that while it seems really messed up and unscientific to us, it was telling us about God's uniqueness and some character traits about who he was and how he was far above any other possible powers. As always, I reserve my right to be wrong and to change my mind if better evidence comes along, but let me tell you a couple of reasons why I think this is so interesting and why I kind of lean towards this viewpoint. The first reason that I believe the creation account is literal and most likely chronological is because of how the rest of the book of Genesis is written. Genesis 1 through 11 has at least four genealogies, and the rest of the book of Genesis is full of genealogies which were clearly meant to be read historically. They are linking God and the beginnings of this nation of called out people. So it's very important to Moses, the author, that he get this right for posterity. He wants us to know how we're connected to the God of heaven. There is absolutely no reason why he would section off the first part of Genesis as sort of a myth story or a deep allegory when the rest of the book is meant to be read as history. Point number two is that if we accept this as both literal and at least somewhat chronological, then we learn huge things and important things about the character of God. So what was God saying about himself by arranging the creation days so strangely? I'm glad you asked, because I think that there is clarity in understanding a couple of words used in the beginning of the creation account. It says that the world was without form and void. The words there are tohu and bohu, without form and void. When you see this, you'll see that God has this really cool pattern that he does, where on days 1 through 3, he creates forms or spaces, and then on days 3 through 6, he fills the void. We'll talk about day 7 in just a second. And what we find is that he creates the space, fills, creates the space, fills, and we find out that he is highly organized, that he is the sustainer of life, that life does not depend on the sun, but it depends on him. We find out that he is a provider. He likes to have things there before the creatures need it. And we find out on day 7 that he could have just been done at day 6 and made like a 6-day cycle, but instead he has a standing day of rest and blessing where he creates a space, puts like a little space marker there, and then it says he fills it with blessings. He sets it apart and makes it holy. So what was God saying about himself by creating the days all out of whack? He was saying, I know this seems illogical to you, but I've got a pattern and I've got a reason for it, and it's going to set me apart as a different kind of God than humanity is going to come up with for the whole rest of eternity. Thanks again for your question, Joanna. And if you have a question about the Bible or Christianity that you would like me to consider for an upcoming video, please let me know in the comments section below or in the description box. You'll find other ways to get a hold of me. If you are in the San Jose, California area and would like to do in-person, non-pushy, non-agenda-based Bible studies, let me know. I would love to meet up with you. And if you've been watching this whole time, thanks so much for being with me today. I'm wishing you joy and peace for your journey, wherever that leads you. Blessings, and I'll talk to you soon. Bye.